Well, congratulations on the movie. I cannot imagine, I can't tell you how many Singaporeans are so anxious to watch it. Tell me, what was the first thing you guys felt when you read the script? And when was it that you said, yes, sign me up for Ridley Scott's return to sci-fi?
Well, I don't know.
For you, it was when you heard I was in it.
Yes,
right?
I knew Charlize was on board. In fact, I did know you were on board before I came on board. And that was an exciting thing for me because we hadn't really worked together properly before. But I don't know. I think from the outset, I mean, just knowing it's Ridley and, you know, looking at the ideas in this script, mm-hmm. it was all highly compelling.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Whereas for you, it was the pay.
Yes.
The pay and a chance to be in London.
Yeah,
and to work with Guy.
Well, she didn't know.
Not so much. No, that was.
That's
probably
why they signed her on before.
That was probably the only negative of this movie. Yeah, I was trying to get him fired the whole time.
It was really awkward.
I'm sure it was on set. You've got that amazing moment, and without revealing too many things to spoil the movie, what was it like, that one poignant, short but poignant scene between both of you? What was it like before going into it? How did you guys work on it?
I don't know. I feel like we work very similarly.
Yeah, absolutely.
I feel like we do the homework before you really show up.
The same sort of work ethic.
Yeah, and there's just a couple of, you know, there was a couple of physical things that we were trying to sort of,
it's like dancing.
Get right.
Yeah, you walk on and you feel like you're with someone who wants to kind of like spread it and kind of play with it, but you know they're not coming completely unprepared, and there's a back and forth that's really great.
A tennis.
Yeah, it's really exciting to work with someone like Guy, especially on a scene like that. Mm-hmm. You know, because there's so many possibilities and there's so much to explore there. And if you have a partner that has that same excitement about wanting to explore it, there's nothing like that.
It's communication as well, isn't it?
My job.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
that's great. You talked about before, Charlize, you talked about how, you know, the whole method thing isn't for you. And similarly, is that the same for you, Guy?
I don't know, because I don't really understand. I mean, I didn't go to drama school, so I don't really know.
It's all organic and natural.
Well, I don't know where the boundaries are. I mean, for me, it just, you know, I have to find it and get there and have it feel real. And sometimes that it's different on different jobs, I find, you know.
Right.
I certainly don't need to, you know, wander the streets as my character in order to feel like I am that character. I've got a pretty vivid imagination, so I'm good with that.
And similar with you, finding your inner villain. I mean, you've been playing all these sort of mean girl roles. I mean, have you found that within you, you think?
You know, they're all different. They're just all, they find themselves in different worlds, and they're actually wanting different things. I think all three of those characters that you're referring to, they you know, they're not perfect and they don't have just amazing human attributes and they don't do everything right, and they take a little work to get to know. And I think actors want to kind of explore complex human beings, because I don't believe humanity is, you know, sometimes when I watch films and I see people just kind of going through life and, you know, everything is great, and then the third act, the music kicks in, and they go through this, like, huge cathartic experience, and they're, like, running down the street, and I'm like,
that's the Hollywood moment. Who are these people,
and
right,
why don't I know them? Like, why does this never happen
why
to me?
Why am I not like that?
Yeah, I call them movie people. I don't know those people.
That's because people go to the movies to escape, and they want that big Hollywood moment at the end, you reckon?
I guess, but, some people want that. We don't necessarily
I actually think that's a huge misconception, because I think when people actually watch something that is real and authentic, they emotionally tap into that way more.
Mm-hmm.
Way more.
That's true.
And this idea of, like, you know, the life is hard and we want to go, that's not what storytelling is about. I mean, the origins of why we share stories is because we want to see ourselves in them. It's like holding a mirror. And whether we want to acknowledge that or not,
to immerse yourself into.
Yeah, and I think that whole idea of, like, fake, happy, shiny people.
So going back to not being method, what was it like on set? I mean, it is a big epic film. It's got huge sets, and you've got a huge cast as well. What was it like on set if you were, you know, not in method at all? Was it fun? Was it social? Logan was saying it was quite a social
set.
Yeah,
it was a lot of fun.
I think people
for the time I was there.
Yeah, I mean, I think what people forget is that making a film is very time consuming. And so they think when you say, oh, we're having fun, it's like, well, you're working. But you're really working a small part of your day. Most of your day is really sitting around waiting.
Or not nicking all the little cool gadgets that you have on the set of Prometheus?
Well, no, we do not approve of stealing.
Right.
but you work with interesting people, and I think our job, I mean, it's what a nice opportunity to kind of like pack up the circus tent and get thrown into a situation with strangers. And yeah, I take full advantage of that. It's fun. It's so much fun.
Do you guys like pull pranks on each other or try and make the work day go a lot quicker?
I don't understand the prank thing.
No?
I'm like, just do good work and have a good time. What's the prank thing?
We had a lot of laughs, but that's just because you're being sarcastic or you're joking or you're being facetious or, you know, you don't have to have like a fart bubble to like create
that.
Yeah,
hide things.
He's a very funny guy, just naturally. He doesn't need any props.
What's your best joke guy then?
It's not about jokes. I think it's just like picking up on little things.
Yeah, picking up on what's going around at the time, you know.
Yeah.
Taking the mickey out of it.
The mickey. How important is a film like Prometheus in this space and in this time, you reckon? I mean, obviously with all the big questions and the big unanswered questions about the meaning of life.
I mean, it's hard to say how important it is. I mean, you know, it might be one of those things that people retrospectively will look back and go, wow, that was important at the time. But it's certainly hard for me to sort of say how important it is. I don't really know. I think what's important is that the film works and that that it's entertaining and that it's thought-provoking, like any film, really. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. I can't tell whether this film is particularly important at this point in time.
How about you, Charlize?
Yeah, I mean, I think it would be a little presumptuous to just kind of assume that this is going to... I think, you know, time is a true teller of what a film kind of leaves behind. And also,
the legacy, really.
Yeah, and I think it's very hard to predict that. And I think if you're setting out to make a film that's really important, then you're probably making it for the wrong reasons. Mm. I think all of us thought these were interesting questions to ask, but we wanted to make an entertaining film.
At the end of the day,
I guess,
isn't it?
The, you know, the question is really, you know, how important to Ridley is this film to make this film, you know, rather than how important is the film on a broader, you know. So it's a question for Ridley about what it means to him, I suppose, this film in his, you know, world of films, I guess. Mm-hmm.